Welcome back to Speller Tutorial Services. In today's video, we're going to construct an angle bisector of a triangle, and we're going to bisect here angle Z or vertex Z of the triangle. So begin by setting your compass to an arbitrary radius, placing the pointy end here on vertex Z, and then making sure you draw an arc that's going to actually cross at two different places, creating two intersections. I'm going to label these intersections A and B. Without changing the radius of the compass, we're going to place the pointy end here on A, and we're going to draw another arc. Let me try to place this. I want to place this in a good location. All right, right there. And let's draw another arc. And then I'm going to come back here to B, and again draw yet another arc. I want these two arcs here to intersect, all right? And I've got my intersection here, and I'm going to call that intersection C. All right, once I draw the straight line from intersection C all the way down here to vertex Z, that there is my angle bisector for the triangle. All right, let's make sure this is lined up as good as we possibly can. So let's come here and then swing this back. Okay, and now let's draw our, whoops, let me undo that so we can just get a nice straight line here. Oh, what's going on? Let's try this again. Let's get our bisector. Let's get this bisector going. So here, there we go. So here we have our bisector. As we learned in previous videos, whenever we bisect something, we cut it in half. In this case, we're bisecting an angle, so that means we're going to cut the angle in half. So to verify that, let's go ahead and pull out our trusty protractor tool here, and we're going to measure these two angles. First, let's make sure that we've got the vertex here on the starting point of our protractor, and then we're going to set this here at angle zero. Alright, so we see, and you know what, one more thing, let me go ahead and also call this here D. So we see here, if we look at angle X, Z, D, we see that measures about 19 degrees. Let's go ahead and rotate the protractor. So now we can measure angle D, Z, Y. And we see that DZY is also, let me see, it's showing about 18. Let me make sure this is positioned properly. Well, we're within 1 degree, so I'll leave it there. We're within a good margin of error. So here, drawing our angle bisector by hand for triangle XYZ, we've just drawn the angle bisector. All right, that sums it up for this video by Speller Tutorial Services. Please friend us on Facebook and also subscribe to our YouTube channel, both found under the name Speller Tutorial. And as always, thank you for watching.